If you're looking to grow your business but aren't sure if the stars are aligned yet, then stay tuned to find out. Hi, I'm Josh from the University of Laverne Small Business Development Center, and here at the SBDC, we help small business owners with free one-on-one consulting and business tip videos just like this one. So if you're new here, consider subscribing to the channel. Scaling your small business is less about finding the right time or the stars aligning and more about building your business systems and growing. How do you know when you should scale your business or if you can? In this video, I'll cover five aspects for you as a business owner to know when to evaluate and scale your business. If you're looking to grow or even scale your business, you need to have a plan. If you created a plan when you started your business, there were some basic milestones you probably set out for yourself. If you're an existing business, these might be goals for, say, the next 1 to 5 years, and this plan should be referred to and updated often, and you must have the appropriate goals and milestones to reach for growth. As a business owner, if you don't meet these milestones, you're not ready to scale your business. Your business's financials are a strong indicator to measure growth and when to scale. While this is true, how you look at your finances and measurements will give you the proper insight for scaling. However, if you simply think booking enough or making enough money is a reason to scale, not so fast. Revenue isn't everything. While revenue is indeed an important factor for growing and scaling your business, it should not be used solely to make that determination. Being profitable is not a great indicator either. Profits may not be consistent. If you sell high-ticket items or are constantly scrambling to close deals, this is the old feast or famine dichotomy, and you should avoid it at all costs, even if on paper you actually make money. A better metric is cash flow. A business's cash flow is a much better indicator of health. If a business has a strong positive cash flow and little expenses, it may be time for your business to start investing to scale. You should monitor your cash flow monthly and make adjustments before things go south. Another indicator regarding your business to know when to scale is your operational success. Your goal for operations should be simplicity. Larger operations will naturally have more complex processes, but if your small business has unnecessarily complex processes, then scaling your business prematurely will only exacerbate those shortcomings. You should strive to simplify and streamline processes to do things better, faster, and cheaper. How do you do that, you ask? Well, if you're looking to scale, invest in technology to make production easier and more efficient. This can include getting new or upgraded software to make processing orders easier. The other way you can scale your business is by investing in your employees. This means training through some professional development courses or new processes. Investing in employees can actually be hiring and training of additional employees to meet an increase in orders or complete jobs faster. The next factor that impacts your ability to scale your business is time. At a practical level, time could be a sign of operational stress and a sign that your business isn't ready to scale if lead times grow. As I mentioned before, your business should strive to make operations simpler, and an indication of that is shortened time between jobs. As a business owner, when working in your business and growing, you'll realize time is not your friend. This is another indicator within our time factor. Many business owners who start out as solopreneurs who struggle to keep up running the business. Time is a double-edged sword, and many business owners work too much in the business instead of on the business and are unable to scale due to operational or resource constraints. One of the most important factors to scaling your small business is managing demand. As a small business owner, you should recognize how demand affects your business and need steady demand to grow. One sign of increasing demand that suggests you need to scale is when you turn down customers because your business cannot take on any more work. If you're looking to grow your business, you need to increase your demand for products. You can do this by investing in marketing and through advertising rather than the large time investment organic marketing may offer. You'll need to evaluate how your customers find you and upgrade marketing channels to make acquiring customers easier or more efficient. One sign of scaling your business regarding your reputation is the need for you to maintain quality throughout your product and service offerings. As you grow as a business, you may encounter an increase in customers, but it may affect the quality of your offerings. If this wavers and quality declines, this could tank your reputation. Even if your business scales properly, you may never be able to bounce back from that. Scaling your small business is more complicated than just making more money or needing more employees. You need to take a hard look at your finances and operations. If you're looking to scale or you plan to scale your business, then contact your local SBDC to plan your business for growth for the future. So, are you ready to scale your business? And do you have any questions on scaling your business today? Let us know down in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, give us a like, share, and subscribe to the channel. It really helps us out. And don't forget to ring that notification bell to get updates on all of our new content to grow your business. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.